Hi, my name is Tess Rogers, and I'm going to be talking about the interactionist theory for my honors contract for Sociology 101. So what is the interactionist theory? Basically, it's a way that we analyze a situation, a certain theory on how we analyze a situation, particularly the verbal and nonverbal communication between two people who come across one another in everyday situations. And according to the textbook, it's a way to seek to understand the social structure that underlies the communication and basically makes up our entire social system. The interactionist perspective is a micro-sociological perspective. So basically what that means is we act toward people and things based on the meaning that we interpret from them. And that meaning we get from social and cultural constructs, so basically previous experiences in our lives or from people who are raising us that teach us how to act around certain things. And basically that understanding of the situation is an ongoing interpretive process during which the initial meaning might be the same, it could evolve slightly, or it could change radically. So the person that I chose to talk about today is George Herbert Mead, who is known as the father of the interactionist theory. He is a prominent American philosopher in social psychology and the development of pragmatism. And I'm just going to give you a little bit of background on his life so that we can basically understand why he came up with the interactionist theory. So he was born in 1863 in Massachusetts, and his father was the pastor of a local church. They then moved to Ohio to be so that his father could be a professor at Oberlin Theological Seminary in 1870, and his mother was also an academic, teaching at Oberlin College and then later becoming president of a different college. So after he grew up, Mead actually enrolled in Oberlin College where his mother taught, and he got his bachelor's in history and literature there. He then kind of bounced around a little bit. He was a school teacher, and then he was a surveyor for the Wisconsin Central Railroad, and then he decided to go to Harvard to study psychology and philosophy. He never actually completed his graduate degree because he went to Germany to follow his friend Henry Cassel and Cassel's sister Helen Cassel, who actually became Mead's wife later in life. Again, he tried to further his education by enrolling in the University of Leipzig's PhD program for philosophy and physiological psychology, and then he later transferred to the University of Berlin where he studied economic theory. So Mead was kind of bouncing all over the place, didn't really finish everything he started, met a lot of people, was in a lot of different situations, different places, things like that. He then was offered a position teaching philosophy and psychology at University of Michigan, and he stopped his PhD studies, his doctoral studies, to go work there. He then met sociologist Charles Cooley, philosopher John Dewey, and psychologist Alfred Lloyd, who all affected his school of thought later. And then he later gained the position of assistant professor at University of Chicago before he died at the age of 68 in Chicago. So basically, Mead's main contribution was his published work called Mind, Self, and Society. He theorized the difference between I and me. So what he called I was the self as a thinking, breathing, active subject in society, and me is what he called the accumulation of knowledge of how that self is an object is perceived by others. So I is basically like whatever I think, whatever I want, how I'm going to go about a situation, whereas me is how others look at me, what others expect of me, how they expect me to act in certain situations. So I think that his school of thought was influenced by both his experiences with religion and his studies, his moving around, his ability to look at different situations, see how people are interacting. He spent lots of time around different kinds of people in different places and different situations, and his education was what allowed him to observe and then try to understand the way people interact. He was always studying psychology, sociology, things within that field. And I think that possibly Mead's religious upbringing and his consistent attempts to finish studying affected his thoughts because he was trying to figure out what he wanted and figured out what he was going to do versus what was expected of him by maybe his father, who was very religious, or by society just in general, expecting people to finish their studies, things like that. But I think that the interactionist theory that Mead kind of streamlined is still applicable to everyday life. So it could be as simple as an example, like when we sit down at a table in a restaurant, we expect that whoever comes up to us is going to take our order. The waitress is there to take our order. So we expect this because of prior social interactions. It's happened in the past. So it's what we expect. But if the person approaches us and it is the waitress and she takes our order, then that kind of reaffirms our expectation of the situation. However, if the waitress comes up and says, you know, actually it's a buffet style, then our expectation is modified. It's shifted a little bit. Another example could be like more applicable to myself. So when we come to college, we expect that our classes are going to be really hard. We think this because of all the people we know, the people who raised us, teachers, parents, they're all telling us that the classes are going to be really hard. If we show up and the classes are really hard, then the meaning of college classes is reinforced. However, if they're easy or not as difficult, our meaning could shift to thinking classes in college are not as hard. So just based on the interaction of the situation, the development of our thought process throughout, that's a demonstration of the interactionist theory in this situation. And one final example is something that I experience as a girl. If I'm walking alone on campus at night, I expect that any man who approaches me is dangerous. And I expect this because of the horror stories that I've heard about, you know, kidnapping, assault, rape, anything else like that. And if a man were to come near me and attack me, then this expectation would be reinforced. However, if a man were to approach me and just ask for directions, something like that, then my expectation would be shifted. So those three examples are how interactionist theory could be applicable to everyday life. Again, the father of this theory was George Meade. And yeah, that would be the interactionist theory. So thank you for your time.